हेटर टाइप आधा काम मत करो, सब्सक्राइब के साथ साथ बेल आइकॉन भी दबाओ।
इंडियन मेडिकल एसोसिएशन ऑन ट्यूसडे कॉल फॉर द विथड्रॉल ऑफ नॉन एसेंशियल एंड नॉन कोविड सर्विसेज ऑन डिसम्बर 11th टू प्रोटेस्ट अगेंस्ट द सेंटर्स डिसीजन टू अलाउ पोस्ट ग्रेजुएट आयुर्वेदा प्रैक्टिशनर्स टू परफॉर्म जनरल सर्जरीज रिलेटेड टू ऑफ्थाल्मोलॉजी एंड डेंटल प्रोसीजर्स। इमरजेंसी सर्विसेज विल कंटिन्यू टू फंक्शन along with intensive care units and cardiac coronary care units. But no elective procedures will be performed during the protest from 6 a.m. to 6 p.m. The medical body announced, it also called for public demonstrations on December 8th and said that participants will adhere to COVID protocols and protest in small groups of 20 between noon and 2 p.m. Last month, the Central Council of Indian Medicine, the regulatory body for the study and practice of Ayurveda in India, amended the Indian Medicine Central Council Postgraduate Ayurveda Education Regulations 2016 to include the regulation to permit postgraduate students of Ayurveda to receive training and practice of Shalya and Shalakya. While Shalya refers to general surgery, Shalakya is related to diseases of the ear, nose, throat, head, eye and orodentistry, terming the decision as a deceptive camouflage of mixing the systems of medicine. The medical body opposed her decision. It is nothing but a blatant attempt at mixopathy and khichdification of medical education and practice, the Indian Medical Association said. The recent policy tilt is evidenced in the medical pluralism advocated by the National Education Policy 2020 and the four committees of Niti Aayog for officially integrating the systems of medicine in medical education, practice, public health and administration, as well as research ostensibly for a one nation one system policy will ring the death knell of modern medicine system as a whole. I'm a national president, Dr. Rajan Sharma said. He added that the notification on Ayurveda surgery as well as the entitlement to study and practice independently have to be seen as another step in advancing and legitimizing mixopathy. The association demanded an immediate withdrawal of the notification, as well as the Niti Aayog's decision to form four committees. IMA will be constrained to intensify the agitation until the steps towards implementing mixopathy are abandoned. The organization's Secretary General R.V. Asokan said, IMA has appealed to all the sister professional specialty organizations, the organizations of medical college teachers, government doctors, resident doctors associations apart from medical students and hospitals associations, to support its cause to retain the separate identity and existence of modern medicine.